Today, I am going to be showing you this variation of the Anubian Death deck that I have honestly had some amazing success with. My current score with this deck is 12-1, so let's immediately jump into it. This deck works by dealing damage to your opponent directly, basically with the afterlife of your creatures and the abilities of your Anubians. For some reason, I find this deck very enjoyable to play. My favorite card in this deck is the Blackfire Fledgling. Basically, this is a dragon that deals 3 damage to the weakest enemy creature and also at the same time your opponent's god. The MVP of this deck is going to be the Burial Worm. As soon as you have the Blackfire Fledgling in your Void, you can activate the afterlife of this dragon. The Canopic Hoarder also works the same way. So basically guys, this deck has a lot of different ways for you to deal damage to your opponent directly. You can bypass frontline creatures, you can very easily break the ward if you're playing against Magic. It is honestly one of the most fun decks that you can play. And while it might seem like a regular aggro deck and you might think that this doesn't really require a lot of thought, the more I started playing this deck, the more I realized that understanding what deck my opponent plays really impacts how I am playing with this deck. So let's immediately dive into some gameplay now so you can see the deck in action. So guys, this is a ranked game where we're playing against the Nature Domain. Having the Necro Scepter in my starting hand is very good for us. Let me get rid of Dangerous Ritual. Honestly, this starting hand is quite okay. And I think I'm going to start with a Bomb Fly, so let me get rid of Raving Necromancer for now. Yep, that's good. Basically playing this Relic on turn 2 is huge. 2 mana for my opponent. They're just going to use their god power, and honestly I think I'm just going to deal 2 damage to my opponent, since this is the case. Yep, and now we're summoning zombies all the way. And the canopy barrage, but we'll take that. Oh, Frostwind Nefer would be huge here, but I think I'm just going to play Brimstone. Let's start with that. Let me play another Brimstone, sadly. Oh, there's the Blackfire Fledgling. We're going to play that on the next turn. So even though I didn't develop any creatures on the board, the Zombie Scepter helps us get a 2 health and 2 strength Lich creature on the board. On the next turn, I'm probably going to play Frostwind Neferu, and this card has been actually rising in popularity very much. I think we're playing against the Food Chain combo. Since my opponent played the Trial Begins, they want to get the Blade Flies in their hand, so we really need to end this game as soon as possible. And this is where Frostwind Neferu comes into play. Because basically when you play this card on an empty board, you are guaranteed to deal at least 4 damage to your opponent. Yep, and the game is over. Just like that, very fast. My opponent realizes that they cannot recover. And this is exactly where this deck shines, guys. As soon as you manage to get the board, this deck makes it very difficult to make a comeback for your opponent. We are playing against Deception in this match. Let's see how we're going to do now. We have the Necro Scepter in my starting hand, that's very good. Honestly guys, I think I'm going to keep this. I am going to play this on turn 1, which might force a removal for my opponent. Then on the next turn, I can play the Necro Scepter to start generating some zombies and follow up with a Blackfire Dragon. Probably this is one of the best starting hands that we can have. Blight Bomb also to help me get rid of a threat if my opponent plays any. So honestly, very good start. Let's see what my opponent has to say about that. Yep, and as I said, I'm going to immediately put the Necro Scepter down to start generating some zombies. And since my opponent is probably playing an aggro deck, having a zombie on the board really helps make sure that we win this game. 3 mana for my opponent. They're going to play. Okay, that's good. I'll take that. Guys, as planned, I'm just going to play the Blackfire Dragon here. And in all honesty, I can just attack this. Since my opponent can play the Echo version of the Blade Borrower here. Okay, that's going to be a Crooked Quartermaster. That's a very decent card. It's looking quite okay for us right now. I have a very easy turn here. I can just trade my zombie onto this. Then I can play the Blight Bomb to get rid of that, to make sure that my opponent doesn't draw any more cards. And I can just play another dragon. Pretty cool stuff. Another one of those, okay. Actually, my opponent has managed to play a really good start to the game. I am going to be playing Untold Greed now to make sure that we draw 2 cards, but first let me play the Vile River to make sure that I get rid of this. Then let me play Untold Greed as planned. That is 3 more damage from my to my opponent. And the Raving Necromancer is good. Burial Worm is also huge. Because it means I can start activating the ability of the Blackfire Dragon in my Void with this Burial Worm. Now there's a very strong frontline creature for my opponent. Let me start by drawing a card, actually. Oh, Pharaoh's Heirloom is quite okay for me here. I can also just play the Burial Worm, in all honesty. Let's deal 3 more damage. Yep. And then I kind of want to attack my opponent with this, at least. Basically because I don't want to be weak to Rapture Dance. Yeah, let me do that. And then I'm just going to end my turn. Another Blade Borer. Okay, that's a little lucky for my opponent. And another one. Okay, there is a Deep Water Whelp. I'm going to make good use of that. Then I'm going to play Pharaoh's Heirloom. Let's finally get rid of you. Then I can also play the Vile River in all honesty. Oh, and the Pharaoh's Heirloom. That was very lucky for my opponent. They got that for my God Power. Oh, dangerous. Actually, this is a huge draw for me. Let's see what we're going to get now. Brimstone is also very good. Oh, and Frost Queen Neferu, but we don't have enough for you yet. Let me just use my God Power, and guys, we might be winning very, very soon. My opponent is looking for an answer with their God Power, which makes me very, very happy. Because basically, I think that when I play Frost Queen Neferu, we're going to win the game. Yep. This game is ours. Let's go. Heal your God for 10. What? No, 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 no. That's not good. I have never seen that card before, actually. Oh, no. My opponent got that by using my God Power. That's very lucky. But still, I think I'm going to play Frost Queen Neferu. I am kind of afraid to do that because it means that I am very, very weak to Rapture Dance. So I think I can wait another turn before I do that. Let me actually attack my opponent directly. Then I'm going to draw one more card by playing you. Let's play this a little smart. Guys, I think we might be winning on this turn. Let's see. I think we have enough to win now, actually. We have 3 damage on the board. Actually, I think we are one off from winning the game right now. I think I can start by playing Reach into the Black. Let's see what that's going to give me. That's good, that's good. Actually, okay, now we can make some trades happen, basically. Then I'm going to play Frost Queen Neferu. Let's trade you here to draw another card. Hunting Trap for my opponent. Guys, my opponent is going to be at 5 health right now. I think we can actually win on the next turn, finally. Oh no! They're going to heal up for 2, but that is still enough for us to win right now. Yep, 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 yep. That was actually a very good game for my opponent. But guys, this is how we can win now. I'm just going to play the Canopy Hoarder. That is going to immediately deal 6 damage to my opponent. And then I can just attack with my dragon and the game is over. That was a very good game, actually a very competitive one. But still, we come out on top. Even though this wasn't the fastest game, we never let my opponent find a way to crawl themselves back into the game. So, yep, another win. Guys, we ended up going 15 wins out of 18 games with this deck. Even though we started at the Auric Gold rank, I climbed up to Diamond very, very easily. I am currently in the Diamond rank. But honestly, this deck is probably one of the most enjoyable decks that I get to play. I don't know why I like it so much. I am going to be giving you the deck list in the description of my video if you want to see the deck and this specific variation for yourselves. this is a very solid deck, because you can end games very very fast. You can also win some prolonged games. I think I can reach Mythic with this deck. Stay tuned and don't forget to subscribe. Before we close this video off, let me remind you that we have an ongoing giveaway for 100 Gads tokens. And all you need to do to enter is make a comment on this video right now. If you win, I'm just going to notify you by replying to your comment, so that's it, that's all you need to do. I handle everything on my part, I really want to make it easy for you to join. This is it for today's video, I really hope you enjoyed it, I hope that you enjoy this deck. Let me know if you have any specific deck ideas that you want to see in my videos next. I'll see you all tomorrow with a brand new video.